watching that garbage. You're blind, baby. You're blind from the facts on who you are because you're watching that garbage. Blind, baby. You're blind from the facts on who you are because you're watching that garbage.
Have you forgotten that once we were brought here, we were robbed of our name, robbed of our language. We lost our religion, our culture, our God. And many of us, by the way we act, we even lost our mind. Have you forgotten that once we were brought here, we were robbed of our name, robbed of our language. We lost our religion, our culture, our God. And many of us, by the way we act, we even lost our mind.
By the time,
yes, sir.
Surely man is in law.
We all agree tonight, all of the speakers have agreed that America has a very serious problem.
You're quite hostile.
I got a right to be hostile, man. My people been persecuted.
In 1968, about 6,000 sheep died near this government facility. They were poisoned by a chemical weapon named VX. The U.S. hasn't been known to actively use VX in combat. In fact, it's begun destroying its stockpile of chemical munitions as part of a UN treaty. But it's just one of many strange and secretive experiments that happened within these walls. Experiments on sheep, mosquitoes, and even civilians. About 85 miles southwest of Salt Lake City is the U.S. government's top secret bioweapons lab. It's called the Dugway Proving Ground. The 77-year-old facility covers about 800,000 acres. That's just a little larger than the entire state of Rhode Island. And it tests some of the deadliest chemical, biological, radiological, and explosive hazards on Earth. Less famous than Area 51, Dugway dates all the way back to 1942, right in the middle of World War II.
The decisive battle of the war already begun.
The government needed a large area to test powerful weapons, eventually settling on this stretch of land in the Utah desert. Back then, the site was used to test everything from chemical sprays and flamethrowers to various antidotes and protective equipment, and even firebombing. After World War II, Dugway mostly shut down until the Korean War began in 1950. That's when the Proving Ground turned into what it is today, a permanent military base. In Dugway's first few decades, the base worked mostly on offensive weaponry, biological and chemical munitions designed to directly attack enemies.
Sampling devices positioned throughout the test area yield valuable information to Chemical Corps researchers.
The 1950s, for example, saw the launch of Operation Big Itch, an experiment that was testing weaponized fleas. The fleas weren't infected with any type of disease or agent, but experimenters were working with thousands of them, and the fleas were dropped in cluster bombs to gauge if they would survive the fall from an airplane. And this was only part one. Dugway launched a second experiment called Project Bellwether in the 1960s. Only this time, mosquitoes were injected with inert diseases, inert bacteria, and inert viruses. But get this, those mosquitoes were released upon several groups of human volunteers who were bitten again and again during the trials. And there are records dating back to the late 1950s, which describe experiments that used infected mosquitoes. And those are just two experiments known to the public, Exactly what goes on at Dugway is, well, pretty unclear.
So we're going to comment on the Pope. The Pope is supposed to be representing Jesus or God on earth, but a lot of people don't know that in the Vatican, I believe, this is just my belief, most of the books are books from the Library of Alexandria, talking about black people. And out of the circle of the Illuminati, now you see the headpiece that the Pope got on, mostly, I can't recall the name of it right now, it skips my mind, but it looks almost like a kufi, but the Jewish people have a name for it, that hat or cap. But he's supposed to be Catholic. I showed a picture called the Day of Wrath, showing how the Jews during the Inquisitions merged in, took over the Christian or the Catholic religion, and prayed like Catholics by day, and in secret prayed like the Jews. And millions of dollars going through Vatican from people who are fooled. Most people don't know that if Mary is black and the baby sitting on Mary's knee is black, how can they be bowing down to a white Jesus? So some trickery right there to persuade the majority of the people to bow down to the cross, which is the double cross, and the Caucasian. Now, the point is this: the world of the Caucasian that we live in is abstract. It's an abstract world or a concept that was birthed by the Caucasian. During our 400, 500 years over here in America, his whole purpose was to conquer God. He is the Antichrist. He's against nature. How can anybody invent germ warfare that could wipe out a whole population or a whole planet of people? Black light.